Om Shanti, today is the 150th day of your Kali blessing, and Baba in this blessing reminds us that you are on a stage and everybody is watching you, and most importantly, he's watching us. So God being the Dharam Raj, that means the protector or the king of all the Dharma. Dharma doesn't mean that which religion do you belong to, but Dharma of the soul means whether you are using anger or you are using peace. Whether you're using love or you're using hatred. Whether you are using jealousy or you're using contentment in your life. And that's what makes each one of us dharmic being. So it's not the tag, it's not the name of the religion that you belong to. It is whether you are in dharma and doing your karma. So the right meaning of dharma is whether we are using peace, love, happiness, bliss, power, patience, tolerance, royalty, loyalty, acceptance, and many more virtues and values in our life, and doing all our karmas. Otherwise, we are not dharmic, even if we are wearing a cross, or we are putting a bindi, or we are wearing a kufi, or we are wearing a turban. It doesn't at all matter as per God. So what Baba wants us to do is, he wants us to change our method of seeing things and working things out. So let's see what Baba has to say in today's blessing. Baba says, may you always perform elevated tasks with the awareness of your perfect stage. What stage are we at? That's what we're going to explore here. And become equal to the Father. Perfect stage and your status, and become equal to the Father. So what status does Baba talk to us about? Let's explore that. Baba says, always be aware that at every moment, at every second, and in performing every action, he's being very particular about every second, every minute, and performing every action, right from the thoughts which we create, to the words which we speak, and to the actions which we do. You are on a stage, and we have to remember that. We think that only the actors on the screen are the ones who are on the stage, but they are doing double acting. Their own physical world acting and the acting for the screen. But we are the true actors. So God says, you are the hero actor or you are the villain actor. You could be a villain in somebody's life, you could be a villain in your own life. Yes, a soul can be their own villain. That means a soul can jeopardize their own future by not following certain rules of karma. God says, be aware of them, be very, very careful. Which side do you take, the hero or the villain? So you are on a stage, that's what Baba says, and by paying attention to your every action, you will come closer to your stage of perfection. God wants us to become like him, not him, but like him. So God wants us to have all the values and all the virtues which we can learn from him. And while meditating, we get those vibrations, we get that energy from God, with the help of which we refine or fine-tune our thoughts, our words, and our actions. It takes time, it's not a one-day process, because there's a lot of muck over here in the mind which needs to be removed. As Baba says, as God says, that you were a 24-karat gold soul, but over a period of time, you started gathering nickel and cobalt and many more things, and slowly, slowly, silver also got in, and your state of mind became impure. So from 24 carat, your carat started reducing, and it has come down to maybe somewhere near to even 8 to 9 carat only. And some of the souls have become further downgraded, impure. So God says, be careful of your thoughts, of your words, and your actions. So then Baba says, let's see, the awareness of these two things, that I am on this stage and I have to achieve a status of divinity from God, which cannot be attained on our own. And no human being, no human soul can give us that status or can give us the energy or the vibrations to reach to that level. That's why God is the Father of all souls. Even the souls who are calling themselves as the gurus, as the pandits, or the fathers, or any other title which human souls are taking. God says, I am even there. Parent. So even they cannot give you or me any form of vibration or energy to transform myself. Human souls don't have that power because they have become impure. Only God has that power to do that. That's why we meditate on God. Then Baba says, The awareness of these two things will make you equal to the Father. Equal to the Father, but not Father. So, in many religions, we say, Hum So. That means we think that I am God or I have God within me. But God says that is not possible. Because He is a separate entity and we souls, His children, are a separate entity. If God was within me, if God was within you, that means you and me would have been fathers of all the souls around. And if God is in every other human being, then all the souls have become fathers. So, where is Godfather then? If all of us are not brothers and sisters in terms of physical feature, but in terms of soul, we are brotherly souls, children of one father. But if we say that God is within us, that means that all of us have become fathers. So who's going to give liberation to whom? Can you give me liberation? Can I give you liberation? If I am the father and you are the father of the humanity, if God is within me, then I cannot give you liberation. I cannot promise that. So how can you promise that? That's why God is separate and we souls, His children, are separate. So God is a separate entity. God is not within us. But His qualities can be within us. His values and virtues can be within me. Okay? And you. So Baba then says, by becoming equal, you will easily be able to catch the thoughts in one another's mind. So if we raise our consciousness to a certain level of purity, then I can understand your vibration, you can understand my vibration, you can understand your husband or wife's vibrations, what they're thinking, what they're feeling. You can even understand the vibrations of other souls and there you can feel their thoughts also. Provided you are purifying your mind. If there's too much of clutter in your mind, too much of impurity, obviously you cannot filter through all the pure information of other souls, what they're feeling. That's why Baba says, meditate, silence your mind so that you can catch other people's frequencies or thoughts. So then Baba says, by becoming equal, you will easily be able to catch the thoughts in one another's mind. That's what, when we call out to God, God listens to us. He doesn't listen to this voice. He is in Paramdham. He can listen to the thought vibrations of us souls when we are praying, oh God, please help me. So that vibration reaches out to him. But imagine if he's got too much of clutter in his mind. If God is worried, God is in stress. I can't imagine that at all. But imagine if he was in that state. If you are praying to him, oh God, where are you? Are you listening to me? Imagine, would he be able to listen or she be able to listen? It doesn't matter whether it's a he or she, because soul is gender neutral. So, God says, then you can have this power of mine also. You can easily be able to listen to other souls. Then what does Baba say then? Baba says, by becoming equal, you will be easily be able to catch the thoughts in one another's mind. For this, you simply need controlling power over your thoughts. It's not that you suddenly become angry, you suddenly get pissed off, you suddenly get agitated, you suddenly become harsh to somebody. You suddenly become jealous, you suddenly become authoritative, you suddenly become egoistic. And all this time when we are phasing through this kind of thought pattern, it is very difficult for any relationship to bloom in any home, any office or any workplace. Because we cannot understand each other. Because there's too much of us or me or I, me and myself within. That's why God says, remove that clutter. Remember which stage you are on, what status you have to achieve. Status, not the worldly status, but the status of being called as God's pure child, a trustworthy child of God. That status God is talking about. And Baba says, for this you simply need controlling power over your thoughts, which comes through meditation, which we learn at Brahma Kumaris. Let there not be any mixture in your thoughts. What mixture are we talking about? Pure thoughts, impure thoughts, waste thoughts, or positive thoughts or negative thoughts. Out of these, what is right and what is wrong, you know it very well. But the detailed version of it can be learned at Brahma Kumaris. So I leave you with this beautiful blessing. Think about which stage are you on. The world stage where God is watching you. Have a blessed day. Om Shanti.